Dear students, after the unit test, this is our first class. Today we will start chapter number 5, Factors and Multiples. Now we will recall the terms factors and multiples. A factor of a number divides a number without leaving a remainder. The multiple of a number is exactly divisible by a number. Now we will discuss some example of multiples and factors. Now, multiples of 5s are 1 5s are 5, 2 5s are 10, 3 5s are 15, 4 5s are 20. Here, 5, 10, 15, 20 are the multiples of 5. That means the table of 5 is the multiple of 5. Suppose we are telling that 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6, 3 3s are 9, then 3, 6, 9 all are the multiples of 3. And what is factor? Here I am dividing 42 by 7. 7, 6 are 42. Here remainder is 0. When we are getting the remainder 0, then we can say that 7 is a factor of 42. Similarly, when we are dividing 276 by 2, we are getting 0 as a remainder. That means 2 is a factor of 276. And when we are dividing 81 by 3, again we are getting 0 as a remainder. That means 3 is a factor of 81. But when I am dividing 38 by 3, we are getting 2 as a remainder. So here, remainder is not equal to 0. We are getting a number. When we are getting a number except 0, that time we will say that 3 is not a factor. 3 is not a factor of 38. So, when we are getting 0 as a remainder, that time we can say that the number, that means the divisor, is a factor. And when we are getting remainder 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, that means except 0, any number we can get as a remainder, that times the divisor is not a factor. Next, prime number. Prime number means the number which have only two factors, one and that number itself. I have written two examples here, 7 and 13. When I am finding the factors of 7 and 13, we are getting the number 7 and 1 for 7. And here for 13, we are getting 13 and 1. That means for both the number, 1 is common and the another factor is the number itself. For 7, the factors are 1 and the number itself, that means 7. And for 13, the number is 1 and the number itself 13. So, when I am getting the factor 1 and the number itself, then the number is called prime number. Composite number means we will get another factor. Here 10, 2 5s are 10. So with 1 and 10 we are getting another two factors, 2 and 5. So 10 is a composite number. And for 28, 2 14s are 28, 2 7s are 14. So we are getting these factors 2, 4, 7, 1 and 28. So except 1 and the number itself, we are getting another factor. That means 28 is a composite number. So prime number means the number has only two factors, 1 and that number itself. And composite number means except 1 and that number, we will get another factor. And what is twin factor? Twin primes means first, we are taking two prime numbers, 5 and 7. 5 and 7 both are prime numbers and difference between these two prime numbers is 2. So, these prime numbers are called twin primes. Here, I have written two numbers, 5 and 13. 5 is a prime number and 13 is also a prime number. But the difference between 13 and 5 is not equal to 2. So, this is not a twin prime number. Okay? So, two numbers will be called twin prime number when the numbers itself is a prime number and the difference between that two prime number is 2, then that numbers are called twin prime numbers. Now we will start exercise 5.1. Question number A. Check if the first number is a multiple of the second number. So in question number 1, there are two numbers. First number is 63 and the second number is 7. We have to check 63 is a multiple of 7 or not. So here I have written that 7 9s are 63. So we are getting 63 by multiplying 9 and 7. That means 63 is a multiple of the number 7. So I have written yes. Why? Question number 3. 53 and 10. 10 5s are 50. 10 6s are 60. So we are not getting 53 by multiplying any number with 10. That means 53 is not a multiple of 10. So write down no. N. Question number 5. 21 and 4. 4 5s are 20. 4 6 are 24. So multiplying 5 and 6 with 4, we are getting 20 and 24. 20 and 24 are the multiple, but we are not getting 21. So 21 is not a multiple of 4. Write down no. N. Next, question number B. List all the factors of the following numbers. So now we will solve this question. Question number B, part 1. 32. First, we are finding the factors. 2 16s are 32. That means we are dividing 32 by 2. 2 16s are 32. Next, 2 8s are 16. 2 4s are 8. 2 2s are 4. So now we will write all the factors of 32. 1 is common for all the numbers, so first write down 1. Then one number is 2. Then find all the combinations. So 2 2s are 4, 4 be a factor. 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 8 is another factor. 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 8 2s are 16. 16 is a factor and the number itself that is equal to 32. So all these are factors of 32. Next, question number 4, 35. 5 sevens are 35. So here I have written 5 first because if you check with number 2, 3, 4, you can see that we can't divide the number 35 by 2 or 3 or 4. We can divide a number 35 by 5. So first I am writing 5, 5, 7s are 35. So the factors are 1 itself, 5, 7 and 35. So these are the factors of 35. Next, question number 5, 49. Now 49 is not divisible by 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And when we are dividing by 5, we are getting remainder. A number, suppose I am doing the rough work here. 5 9s are 45. So 4 is a remainder. That means 5 is not a factor. But when we are dividing 49 by 7, we are getting 7 7s are 49. So the factors are 1, 7 and 49. Because 1 and the number itself is common for all the numbers. Next one, sum number 6, 72. 72 is divisible by 2. 2 36 are 72. 2 18s are 36. 2 9s are 18. 3 3s are 9. Now we have to write down all the factors. 1, 2, 3. 3 3s are 9. 3 3s are 9, 9 2s are 18. 3 3s are 9, 9 2s are 18, 18 2s are 36 and the number itself 72. 2 2s are 4. 2 3s are 6. 2 2s are 4 2s are 8. 2 2s are 4. 4 3s are 12. 2 2s are 4. 4 2s are 8. 8 3s are 24. 2 2s are 4. 4 2s are 8. 8 we have already written. So these are the factors of 72. Thank you, children.